Okay, you see, email address is nothing more than the amount of attack in the internet, that's very big value. So now I am taking the derivation of constant volume heat addition process. Constant volume heat addition process is as a macro cycle. So in the other cycle, we will be having a four process. One is adiabatic compression. Second one is constant volume heat addition, and third one is adiabatic expansion. Fourth one is constant volume heat rejection. So for adiabatic, we already discussed. Adiabatic means Q is equal to 0. If Q is equal to 0, entropy is constant. This one is equal to S. So constant volume heat addition means V is equal to constant. You can take V by T is equal to constant. Next, adiabatic expansion. Here Q is equal to 0. So S3 is equal to S4. Next, constant volume heat rejection. Again, V is equal to constant. By D is equal to constant. You can take this process 1 to 2, here process 2 to 3, process 3 to 4, process 4 to 1. Okay, so now we need to represent all these 4 processes in PE and TS diagram. So, we will represent PE and TS diagram. So, first I will write adiabatic compression. So adiabatic compression means it is a curve, as we already discussed in the later stories. So adiabatic compression means it is a curve, means volume is decreasing, pressure is increasing. So we need to represent the curve. Okay, it is moving upward, decreasing, volume is decreasing, pressure is increasing. So next, what is next? Constant volume heat addition process. So volume is in x-axis. So if it is a constant, so we can take it as vertically upward line. So we have to take it as a vertically upward line. This is a point P. So what next? It is a constant. No? Next one is adiabatic expansion. Again, it is a curve, but volume is increasing, pressure is decreasing. So you can take it as a curve. Okay. So next process is what? It is a constant volume rejection. Again, it is a downward. So it is going downward. This is a 4 and this is 1. So it is a V is equal to constant. V is equal to constant. This one is compression process. This one is expansion process. Okay. So next we can represent this directly. You can take V2 is equal to V3 and here V1 is equal to V4. Okay. So PE is over. Next, you wanted to represent same thing in TS diagram. So TS, take T, S. So TS, first we take a adiabatic compression. I already told Q is equal to 0, entropy remains constant. Entropy remains constant, entropy is in x-axis. You can take vertical upward line. 1, 2, 3. So next one is what? Adiabatic constant volume heat addition. So constant volume heat addition, you can take here. So next one is adiabatic expansion. Adiabatic expansion, Q is equal to 0, S3 is equal to S4. You can take downward line. So next, constant volume heat rejection process. So constant volume heat rejection process, you can join it. So this is point 3, and this is point 4, and this is point 1. So here you get Q in, and here you get Q out. Okay, so next we will start the derivation now. Okay, so these are now how to represent PE and auto cycle in PE and TS diagram. So now we will start the derivation. So first one is first process. Process 1 to 2 is adiabatic compression. Adiabatic compression means Q is equal to 0. So entropy is constant, S1 is equal to S2. So if I represent this, T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 over R1. Okay. So next process, process 2 to 3. Process 2 to 3 is what? Volume is constant. Okay. So V by V is equal to constant. So here you can represent this. Q thing is equal to MCV T3 minus T2. Okay. So next process 3 to 4. Process 3 to 4 is adiabatic expansion. Adiabatic expansion. Again Q is equal to 0. S3 is equal to S4. So you can represent this as an expansion. And one thing you have to remember, in the compression you take initial volume to the final volume. But in expansion you take final volume to the initial volume. Okay. So temperature is reverse. T3 by T4. What is the initial volume? V3. Well, what is the final volume? V4. So in expansion I have to take initial volume to the final volume. So therefore V4 by V3 power gamma minus 1. So what is the next process? Process 4 to 1. Here it is. V is equal to constant. If V is equal to constant means V by T is equal to constant. So we will get Q out. So Q out is equal to MCV T4 minus T1. So now I am denoting AS1 efficiency. So N of A is equal to Q in minus Q out divided by Q in. So which is also equal to 1 minus Q out divided by Q in. So you can take 1 minus Q out is MCV T4 minus T1, MCV T4 minus T1, and Q in for MCV T3 minus T2, MCV T3 minus T2. You can cancel out CV, MCV. So in the numerator you can take T1 is common, T4 by T1 minus 1, and in denominator you can take T3 is common, so T3 by T2 minus 1. So now I need to prove T4 by T1 is equal to T3 by T2. So to prove T4 by T1 is equal to T3 by T2, so first I take process 1 to 2. What is the process 1 to 2? It is an adiabatic compression. So it is T1 is equal to V1 by V2 gamma minus 1. Similarly, I take process 3 to 4. So 3 to 4 is adiabatic expansion. So you can take T3 by T4 is equal to V4 by V3 power gamma minus 1. But from PV diagram, so you know that V4 is equal to V1 and V2 is equal to V3. So therefore, T3 by T4 is equal to V4 is V1 and V3 is V2 power gamma minus 1. So which is equal to what? T2 by T1. T2 by T1. So therefore, you can write T3 by T4 is equal to T2 by T1. Or you can rewrite this. You want T4 by T1 and T3 by T2, right? So you can repeat change. So T4 by T1 is equal to T3 by T2. So now next one will cancel. So therefore you can rewrite 1 minus T1 by T2. So this is the gas standard efficiency. And the next you can take gas standard efficiency is equal to 1 minus 1 by T2 by T1. Okay, so here you get one process, compression process, compression ratio, okay, is RC. So what is the compression ratio? Compression ratio is, so adiabatic compression means initial volume to the final volume. So compression begins to the compression and ends V1 by V2. Volume at compression start and volume at compression end. So this is called as RC. So therefore, which is equal to, you know, T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 power gamma. So therefore, what is the V1 by V2? It's RC. So which is equal to RC power gamma minus 1. Therefore, T2 by T1 is equal to what? RC power gamma minus 1. So substitute in the air certain efficiency equation. Therefore, you get NRA is equal to 1 minus 1 by RC power. So this is the restaurant efficiency of auto cycle. Okay, see, now I calculate restaurant efficiency derivation. So next I take of mean effective pressure derivation from auto cycle. So for mean effective pressure, the same thing will continue, the same process, adiabatic compression, constant volume addition, adiabatic expansion, constant volume reduction. Same PV diagram, same PS diagram, and then process 1 to 2 is process 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1 is same. Okay, but there is a difference in last time I completed air standard efficiency, now I have to do mean effective pressure. So, what is the definition of mean effective pressure? Mean effective pressure. So, mean effective pressure, the bracket I take PM, is also called as average pressure obtained in the power stroke, okay, in the working cylinder. So what is the mean? So mean effective pressure is also equal to work done to the swept coil. Work done to the swept coil. So swept coil equals, see, work done is from Q minus Q. So swept coil means, see, swept coil is a, so now I have to take into consideration. See, here there is a PV diagram. I am taking a PV diagram of auto cycle. Here 1, 2, 3, and 4. See, it is a V1 and here it is a V2. Okay. So the gap between V1 and V2 is called as step volume or stroke volume. Okay. And then the V2 is a clearance volume. So now, how to take the swept volume? So V1 minus V2 is the swept volume. So in the swept volume, I take V1 minus V2. Okay. So next, we need to know how to find out the V1 and V2. So first, we will see find out. See, what is the V1? By using perfect gas equation, V1 is equal to MRT1. Okay. So V1 is equal to MRT1 by T1. Okay, so next you want to find out V2. V2 is biasing compression ratio, RC is equal to V1 by V2. Okay, then what about V2? So V2 is equal to V1 by RC. Okay, so what is V1? V1 is equal to MRT1 by T1. So substitute MRT1 by T1 into RC. Okay, so now V1 and V2 is over. So next, therefore PM is equal to PM is Q minus Q over by V1 minus V1. What is the QA? So QA is MCV TV minus T2. Okay. So minus Q. What is the Q? MCV T4 minus T4. Minus MCV T4 minus T1. Divided by, what is the V1? V1 is MR T1 by V1. MR T1 by V1. Minus, what is the V2? MR T1 by T1 into RC. Minus MR T1 by P1 into RC. So you have cancel out the MRs. Okay. Then I take R T1 by P1 is common and CV is common. So if you take CV is common, you can take T3 minus T2 minus T4 minus T1. You will find, you can take R T1 by P1 is common. So if you take common, you get 1 minus. So here, see, I take T1 in the numerator, T1, then T3 minus T2 minus T4 minus T1 divided by R T1 into, here you get RC minus 1 by RC. Okay, so now express all temperature temperatures express all temperatures in terms of T1. Express all temperature in terms of T1. So first I have to take this, I have to express T2, T3, T4 in terms of T1. So to take T2, I take process 1 to 2. What is the process 1 to 2? It is T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 power gamma minus 1. But V1 by V2 is what? RC. So RC power gamma minus 1. Therefore, you get T2 is equal to T1 RC power gamma minus 1. So you can take this as equation number 1. And you can take this as equation number 2. So T2 is over. Next, we need to go for T3. So to find out T3, let's go with the process 2 to 3. What is the process 2 to 3? V is equal to constant and P by T is equal to constant. So P2 by T2 is equal to P3 by T3. Or you can write P3 by P2 is equal to P3 by T2. Okay. So here one ratio is entered. So that is an explosion ratio. Explosion ratio is equal to alpha, so which is equal to P3 by P2. So P3 by P2 is pressure at end of the constant volume heat addition, pressure at beginning of the constant volume heat addition. So that is an alpha. Okay. So now therefore T3 is equal to T2 into alpha. What is the T2? T2 is T1 RC gamma minus 1, which is up to you. So T3 is equal to T1 RC power gamma minus 1 into alpha. Okay, take equation number 3. Okay, so T2, T3 is over. Next, we wanted to go for T4. So here, use process 3 to 4. So T2 to 4 is adiabatic expansion. So you will get T3 by T4 is equal to V4 by V3 power gamma. Okay, so but from P diagram, V4 is equal to V1, V3 is equal to V2. So therefore, T3 by T4 is equal to V1 by V2 over gamma minus 1. You want T4, right? So T4 is equal to T3 into V2 by V1 over gamma minus 1. Or you can look at this T4 by T3 into 1 by RC over gamma minus 1. What is the T3? T1 RC gamma minus 1 into alpha. So T4 T1 RC over gamma minus 1 into alpha and 1 by RC over gamma minus 1. So RC over gamma minus 1, RC over gamma minus 1 can cancel. Okay. T1 into alpha. This is equation number 4. So now substitute equation 4, 3, 2 in equation 1. Therefore, Pm is equal to, so Pm is equal to Cp, Cp into T1. So T4, T3, T3 is on what? T1 RC power gamma minus 1 into alpha minus T2. T2 is what? T1 RC gamma minus 1. T1 RC power gamma minus 1. Next, minus T4. T4 is what? T1 alpha minus T1. Divided by, you get R T1 RC minus 1 divided by RC. Okay, so here T1 is common throughout, so you can take and get cancelled. So RC, I take this RC to the numerator, RC to T1, and I take CV to the denominator. And here T1 is over, RC gamma minus 1 is common, I take RC gamma minus 1 is common. Okay, into alpha minus 1 minus alpha minus 1 divided by, and take R by CV into RC minus 1. Okay, so again, I wanted to divide it for R by C. So you know Cp minus Cv is equal to 1. So Cv take out, you get Cp by Cv minus 1 is equal to 1. So R by C is equal to gamma minus 1. C by C is gamma 1. Okay, so now substitute RC P1. So here again alpha minus 1 is common. We take alpha minus 1 is common again into RC power gamma minus 1 into minus 1 divided by R by C is what? R by C V gamma minus 1. Gamma minus 1 into RC minus 1. So this is the mean effective derivation of auto cycle.